Dear followers, welcome to this short tutorial. We are going to see all the main 2D features inside Autodesk AutoCAD 2020. Make sure to visit our YouTube channel and our website to get extra tips, videos, and participate in our giveaway campaigns. Any 2D project in AutoCAD is made by several objects such as arcs, circles, line segments, and polylines drawn as curves, polygons, or custom closed shapes. All of these can be modified by using all the tools inside the Modify section under the Home tab. To start editing, you can enable any tool, select all the interested objects, and use the Enter key. You can also make your selections first and then enable the tool right after. As other tools inside AutoCAD, you can use the Escape key to undo anything in progress. Use Move, Scale, and Rotate to move, size, and rotate the object selected. Enable Stretch to stretch any element from any of its vertices and sides selected with the Lasso selection tools. Other tools allow to make copies of selected objects, like the Copy tool for simple copies. The Offset tool to keep a constant distance from the selected object, and the Mirror tool to mirror from a defined axis. You can use the Array tool to make full arrays with a rectangular shape, around 360 degrees with polar array, and among a path defined by a selected curve. Then drag from the blue nodes and arrows to adjust the array, such as its number of copies and their relative distance. Enable the Trim and the Extend tool to cut or extend parts of objects that meet the borders of others selected. Use the Fillet and Chamfer tool to create curved and sharp vertices by intersecting the two selected sides. AutoCAD also includes the Hatch tools, which apply filling to 2D closed shapes. With Hatch enabled, click within any closed shape to create a filling on it. You can go on dropping others, sharing the same properties, or create independent fillings by exiting from the Hatch tool every time you create one. The filling created is also associated with its boundaries, so it gets updated every time this is modified. You can also make the filling independent by moving it out from its boundaries. To manage any filling, select it and use the Hatch Editor tab above. Apply any solid color, any gradient, or pattern, adjusting style on the pattern selection and other options such as color, pattern size, and transparency inside properties. AutoCAD also includes several tools to add 2D text and measurements inside the Annotate tab. From the extreme left, you can drop two different kinds of text, multi-line text and single-line text. Multi-line text is used to drop complete and long text paragraphs. Just create the basic text area, which delimits the region where text can spread and distribute from the top to the bottom. Then type inside and use the text editor to adjust the text style and properties, including color and background. To apply text, just click outside. This becomes an independent object that you can move and manage as other 2D objects. You can double-click on it to open it and edit its contents again. To drop simple annotations, you can use the single-line text. Click on any point, set the text height and inclination, and then type in. You can add annotations continuously by fixing several points, finishing with the Escape key. Inside the Dimensions section, set what to measure between sides, angles, or any object radius. Then enable the Dimension tool and define the measurements directly on the objects interested. As seen for the text, these annotations can be moved and edited freely as standard 2D objects. By default, the measurement units are decimal for the length and degrees for the angles, but you can adjust these by going to Manage Dimension Styles. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel and our guide to discover more about AutoCAD and other software for free.